developing overnight, a frightening situation for Florida State University students after police say a gunman stormed the library around 11:30 last night.
This morning, we know that that gunman is dead and at least three people are injured. And we just learned that classes are canceled for the day. Five Eyewitness News reporter Brandi Powell is tracking all of this morning.
Well, Megan, a press conference with Tallahassee police is expected to begin any moment now. We do have some live pictures I want to show you here of them getting set up for that. You can see right there. We're hoping to learn more about what happened, who perhaps the gunman was, if in fact the people who were shot may have been Florida State University students. That should begin again any moment now. Well, here's what we do know, though. Officers opened fire on the suspect after suspects shot at them. ABC News is reporting two of the three victims were taken to the hospital. One of them is in critical conditions. And I want to show you now some video that a student supposedly from FSU put onto YouTube just moments after the gunfire happened.
There has been a shooting in the library. Stay where you are. If anybody has a victim, if anybody has been shot, call 911 on your cell phone. If you have not been shot or you do not know somebody was armed, do not call 911.
Now, this is a big campus home to 41,000 students. FSU student Blair Stokes ran up for safety to the fourth floor of this library. She tweeted her experience moment by moment. Here you can see Stokes shows how students left behind their belongings trying to escape to safety. Then a tweet from another student showing crowded students there in the library, and Stokes again tweeting when cops came to get the students, and finally what it looked like when some of the students got outside. Now, it's unclear again at this time if some of the people that were hurt were FSU students, but clearly very nerve-wracking inside of there. It was hard to hear in that audio, but I've listened to it. One of the students even whispering, "Oh, Jesus," as the police were telling them what to do. We're going to continue to follow the story, and again, that press conference is coming up soon, so I'll bring you the latest from that. Megan.
Okay, Brandi, we appreciate that.
Due to Tallahassee, where a news conference is underway, hoping to get some more information about a shooting that happened on campus late last night. We don't have audio from this. Okay, well, we're going to continue to monitor this up in the production booth right now, hopefully get some more information about this. We do know a gunman opened fire in the library at campus. He is now dead. Three people are injured. Okay, let's listen in.
Turn the podium over to Chief Michael DeLeo. He will speak about the investigation, and then he will introduce the next speaker.
Thank you, David. Good morning. First and foremost, and after any type of tragic event like this, everyone's thoughts and prayers are first and foremost with our victims and their families at this time. Obviously, this will have long-lasting effects with all of them, and that's our priority first and foremost, is to the victims and their well-being. As Officer Northway just said, the next priority is to reassure everyone that there is no indication of any additional threats to the university, the students, or our community at this time. All indications that we have, based on the information right now, this is an isolated incident and one person acting alone. So we want to reassure everyone of their safety and that this is an isolated incident in nature and it was just one person. And there is no indication of any further threat to anybody. Our team of first responders performed admirably this morning. And when I say our team, I'm not talking just about the Tallahassee Police Department. It's the FSU Police Department. They were the first primary responders, along with some of the TPD, also Leon County EMS, Tallahassee Fire Department. We also have local representatives from the FBI who responded to offer their assistance as well, which is the normal protocol in an active shooter type situation of everyone responding and pulling together. All these agencies responded together. That is reflective of all our previous joint preparation and training for critical incidents such as these. And this is why we focus so much attention on working together, planning together, and openly and constantly communicating with each other for these, thankfully, very isolated incidents, but we do pre-plan and pre-train for these incidents and hope to never have to use them. But our response last night, and when I say our response, I'm talking about everyone involved, is indicative of the importance of that training and why we do, why we invest so much time and effort in that. We are also combining all of our resources to ensure the well-being of our victims and our students. And what I'm talking about is our victim advocates, our crisis counselors. We're all pulling our resources to ensure that they have what they need as we work forward from this morning's incident and work towards the recovery phase and make sure that they have what they need to recover and move on. And whether it's witnesses, bystanders, and other people who are affected by the incident. With that, Officer Northway said, we're going to continue the investigation. It will take not only hours, but days to put all the pieces together. Obviously, everyone wants to know why, and that's the hard question that we're going to continue to investigate and try to find those answers for everybody. With that, I'd like to introduce Chief David Perry from the Florida State Police Department.
Thank you, Chief. Good morning. Just to add to what Chief DeLeo has already given you and David Northway.
Say so, one gunman is dead, three students injured on a shooting at Florida State University campus.
It happened at the library last night around midnight. Our reporter Brandy Powell is monitoring this live from our newsroom. She'll continue to watch this live interview happen, and we will check in with her for another update in just a couple of minutes.
More news when we come back.